I had a list of like, here's why I left and kind of the endless meetings and the politics. At first I thought I could just change companies and I would be happier. And then I realized I just wanted to get out of corporate altogether. The thing that I like the best is everything that Edward Jones told me throughout the hiring process and during the training process has happened. You know, so they said in year one, you should expect this. And that's exactly what happened. When something big's going on, people like to meet you in person. You end up being part of their extended family. You know all about their finances, but then all about their hopes and dreams and family and, you know, the good and the bad. It's much more personal. You feel like you're their partner instead of just a salesperson.
We've pioneered a style of education that has consistently challenged the status quo. Early on, it was considered rebellious and alternative.
This school, I don't think would have took place 50 years ago. This school is really a one of a kind. You are truly 21st century.
You guys represent so many positive things in the industry. What you guys do, the school pride, the giving back, you feel it in every hallway. You feel the family bond. It's actually real here.
I think that a lot of things that I'm concerned about and interested in are exemplified by the work that I've seen going on here at Full Sail. It's what I applaud so much, that for the future, we have to focus systematically on developing imagination.
Today, over 50,000 graduates have left their indelible mark as leaders shaping pop culture for the world in entertainment, media, arts, and technology. As a result, educational institutions of all types and all levels have attempted to imitate, but cannot duplicate. We are Full Sail University, headquartered from our campus in Orlando, Florida. A proud member of a collection of colleges and universities throughout the U.S. that include the Los Angeles Film School and the Rocky Mountain College of Art and Design.
Well, hello, ladies, and a couple of gentlemen. How's everybody doing tonight? You look great.
Woo.
Good to see you all. So it looks like our vendor activity worked, right? Did you guys get a lot of talking, a lot of networking done? Good. All right, so we are ready to begin. Welcome to everyone. My name is Mary Beth Plank Mezzo. I am the Vice President of Staff and Cultural Development for Full Sail University. That just means that I get to work with 2,200 fantastic professionals at Full Sail University.
Pretty awesome.
And be responsible for their development. But I'm also excited to be able to work with members of the community, like this young lady right here, Maria Fair.
Yay, my name is Maria Fair. And not only am I a financial advisor with Edward Jones, but I'm also the leader for new growth strategies for women at Edward Jones in the state of Florida.
That's so great. And, you know, people from around the world come to Full Sail University to pursue their educational goals. And they share one thing in common, which is a passion for an education in the media and technology industry. You and I have a passion, too.
Absolutely, which is why we're here today.
That's right. We're here because we are impassioned about empowering women. So it looks like we have a wonderful group of you guys here today.
In our industry, it's especially important that we meet the needs of women. Did you know that 70% of our nation's wealth that is belonging to baby boomers will be passed on to their children by women? That is huge. It's an incredible opportunity. And women also dominate decisions about household finance. And in fact, when women decide or the household decides they need a financial advisor, they prefer to work with the women. And women are generally the ones that make the decision. So we view it at Edward Jones as our obligation to focus on the success of women. And that's a big part of why we're sponsoring and co-hosting this event tonight.
Absolutely. So tonight I hope we empower some women. We're going to learn some power poses. Let's get our power poses ready with the help of our keynote speaker, Susan Constantine. And we'll talk about that in just a couple minutes. But we also have networking opportunities for you guys. Of course, we had a networking opportunity earlier with our vendors. A little bit later in the program, after Susan, we're going to do another networking opportunity with each other. It's very important. Opportunities, networking leads to big things. As a matter of fact, the reason why we're here today is through networking.
Networking was incredible.
Yeah, I went to my very first networking event, and I put it out there into the universe that I wanted to network with people from around the community. An hour later, I get an email from this young lady right here talking about networking. So, and then that started everything, didn't it?
Started everything. And what's even more cool and pretty amazing is that our keynote speaker tonight came from networking. I actually attended an Edward Jones event for female financial advisors, and she was the keynote speaker there and had an opportunity to meet her, and then she joined our Women's Leadership Initiative. So networking leads to a lot of amazing things. Now, I want to make sure that before we get started, we do want to thank some of our sponsors.
Absolutely. Right?
And we want to make sure that we identify, of course, I have to tell y'all, and y'all know I'm Southern right now. Am I giving my Southernness away? I'm not originally from Florida, so you probably figured that out. But Arthur's Catering is doing my son's wedding on December 17th. So thank you for being an amazing sponsor. Thank you also. I'm looking forward to the wedding. Also want to thank iPose Media.
Right,
they're
back here.
They do some incredible things. Be sure you wave back there. Be sure you go back there and visit them. It's pretty cool. And of course, Full Sail University. We could not be doing this event without Full Sail.
Oh, thank you. And what about Edward Jones? Thank you so much to Edward Jones for partnering with us on this one. But we also have many other sponsors here this evening, too many to name, but it's very important that we thank you. Raise your hand if you're with one of these organizations.
I see a lot of you out there.
Thank you. Now, I know we're ready to get started, but don't we need to do a couple of giveaways?
We need to do some prizes. We're going to give away some prizes. So Jessica's coming up with the fishbowl here. We're going to grab out some business cards. I know we have eight. Let's grab some here.
All right.
See how many that is.
All right. I'll just grab this first person. And what we're going to do is we're going to call your name. The prize table is way in the back. Raise your hands over there. These guys over here. So we've got Suzanne Stanley can go and get her prize. Jackie Nitty. Okay, that's two. We've got Gina Brooks, three. Donna Jean Flood. Nicole Jimenez. Mrs. Ronnie DeNoia, director. This is Jean Bruckert. All right, how many is that?
Seven.
Okay, one more. We've got Neon Cowboys. Asia Hall. All right, Asia. All right. Yeah, I'll put the rest of these in here.
We like giving prizes.
Absolutely. Okay, what's next, Maria?
Well, I get the pleasure of sharing with you some information about our keynote speaker. Susan Constantine is the world's leading authority on leadership and deception detection. In fact, she has written a book called The Complete Idiot's Guide to Body Language and has for the past decade worked with media outlets to analyze public officials, politicians, celebrities, and in fact works on a lot of really interesting cases in courts where she works to analyze people's body language. Casey Anthony. She was actually an analyst for that, by the way.
That's right.
The media regularly turns to Susan for U.S. and global leaders, celebrities, to get their analysis of what the leaders are saying in their body language. And she's appeared in more than 1,000 television programs, which I think you may have seen or you're going to see here in just a minute. I'm about giving it away with Dr. Phil. So you'll see a little bit of that. And before I actually bring her out on stage, I want to share with you that tonight she's going to be talking to you about silent messages, the verbal and nonverbal messages that you send and you receive to others. So before we bring her out on stage, I want to share with you a little bit of Susan's work with a short video.
Thank you, guys.
Hi, my name is Susan Constantine, and I am a body language expert and leadership coach.
Okay, everyone get a really good look at your partner next to you, because I'm going to tell you if that person's going to lie to you.
I got the feedback that I knew I was going to get. Susan was one of the favorite keynotes.
Body language expert specializing in human behavior and facial recognition, Susan Constantine.
Well, my general conclusion is when I looked at both the photographs, there was a high level of similarity.
I've had over 1,000 national appearances on television. I'm asked every day almost to be on some show or to be quoted in a magazine. And the reason why they do that is because of, out of all of the experts out there, I give them content, good content every single time that's consistent, reliable, and accurate.
To find out if somebody's lying, first of all, the first thing we have to do is create a baseline. How does someone normally respond in a normal situation when they're not under pressure?
They may even put their hands over their mouth. These are little things, little clues that your little one is lying to you.
This training that I provide are for anyone that wants to be a better communicator, both verbally and non-verbally, and to increase their interpersonal skills.
They didn't know what to expect. They didn't know what it was that she could offer to them. They didn't know at all anything Susan Constantine. But as soon as Susan stepped on that stage, as soon as the interaction, the engagement, the knowledge that she started speaking for them to absorb and to go out and put into fruition in their life, astronomical.
Take someone's posture, shoulders back, shoulders slumped.
What we find is that people that broaden have more confidence and dominance. Those that retract, they lose confidence, become small, and they become more insecure.
Go to your closet and you don't feel powerful in it, you don't feel successful in it, you don't feel like you're on top of your game, urge it and get rid of it.
I help individuals and employees to identify what their top five strengths are. These are the topics we're gonna cover. One is we're gonna learn about what is that mating call? What is it that people do to let you know that they're interested? I'm really excited about all my online training programs that are available on demand instantly at your access at any time during the day or week.
Susan Constantine was a necessity for the seminar. I knew the importance of having somebody of her expertise at the seminar. I was floored by the engagement that she had with the audience, how interactive it was, how the women, as soon as she stepped up on that stage, how it is that they saw the importance of having her there and being a listener to the words that she spoke.
When I see those eyes light up and they are engaged and excited, that's what motivates me, knowing that I have impacted their life in some way, that when they leave, that they can actually use the skills that I've trained them to become more productive, profitable, and more marketable out in the field.
Good evening, ladies. Wow, look at this group out here. Beautiful. Thank you so much for having me here today. I got a question for you. How many of you are ready for a breakthrough tonight? I want to hear it. I want to hear yes. How many of you want to be more promotable, marketable, and profitable in your business going forward? Raise your hand. I want to hear yes. That's what I want to hear. I'm so excited. Guess what we're going to talk about today? Body language. That's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about your interpersonal skills, helping you to be able to communicate better, more verbally and nonverbally. So before we get started, though, each and every one of you have to be sworn in. So I'd like you to raise your right hand and repeat after me. I solemnly swear to tell the truth. The whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. Keep your hand up and look at your partner next to you. Notice if the fingers are open or closed, or does the wrist slightly bend backwards? All righty, take a really, really good look to your partner, because I'm going to tell you whether they're going to tell you the truth or whether they're going to lie to you. You can put your hands down. The person with their hand up like this, with their fingers wide open, they will tell you the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Oh, but they're going to give you so much information you really don't need to hear at all. The person with their hand like this, their fingers tightly together, this is when everybody gets quiet. They will also tell you the whole truth and nothing but the truth, but you have to pull every word out of them. If your hand is like this, wrist slightly bent back, shame, shame, shame on you. You're the one that will tell the story to get yourself out of a little hot water if you need to. And we can see an example of that right here. So I have to share with you a little bit. I have been in the eyes and the ears of the courts for a long time. I actually watched the jurors during a trial. And yes, I was in there in the courtroom during the Casey Anthony and the George Zimmerman. And some of you may have even heard about the Jody Arias case or the Michael Jackson case or some of those other big ones. Well, I read their body language. Anyone can learn how to read body language if they're trained. Women are the best. Yes! We're much better communicators, more verbally and nonverbally, unfortunately, gentlemen, than you. But with the proper training, you all can be really good at reading body language. So we're going to talk about body language, because people in life will be making snap judgments based on our nonverbals, correct? Ladies, when we meet someone, especially another lady that we don't like, are we not really quick to just really sum them up in like two words or less? And it's like, right? Either we like them or we don't just within the first few seconds that we meet them. It's true. So how we present ourselves and our nonverbal communication is directly affecting how kind of responses we're going to get back from other people. When we close ourselves up and become more distant and not engaged and we're not authentic, people can read that, and you won't propel your career that way, but literally you'll be sending them away.
That's what I'm talking about, that first impression. When the first, 35, 40 seconds of meeting with somebody, we've already summed them up. And it doesn't change, ever. It takes forever for them to change their opinion of you or of them. So what is body language? Body language is a combination of our gestures, our face, our tone, our movements. All of that is a part of our nonverbal communication. Humans, just like non-humans, communicate two ways, verbally and nonverbally. So the study of reading people is really fascinating because they can give way of how people are thinking and feeling. In fact, isn't it true that you could actually meet someone and just by watching their body language and look at their face, you can tell there is a story? By the wrinkles on their face, by the way they hold their shoulders, the way they maybe make hold their shoulders back, or whether they make eye contact or avert eye contact, the way they speak, if they're quiet or whether they're more boisterous, it's telling you their story. You can learn a lot about humans just by watching their body language. And guess what part of our body gives away everything? How many of you? The face. The face is the one part of our entire body we can't control. They are these movements that we have, we call micro expressions or subtle movements in our face. It's all connected to what? Do you know what it's connected to? What? Our emotions. Everything that we are thinking and feeling will be exhibited through our nonverbal and our verbal communication. And I'm going to share a little bit about that later on. But based on your nonverbals, this is how they're viewing you. They're determining whether you're confident, you're competent, whether you're likable, whether you're trustworthy, whether I can even trust you or not, just on how you present yourself in your nonverbal communication. So what you're going to learn today are the 7 power moves. How many of you want to know the 7 power moves? Yes, ladies, I'm going to teach you the 7 power moves and also, too, the 2 words that will change your life. Yes, I want. What was that? What was that one more time? Woo! Okay. So body language is nothing more than what we call our thoughts revealed. Whatever we're thinking will be exhibited. If we're not feeling very good, you know, what is the body language when you're not feeling very good? Everyone show me what that looks like. Right? You're not having a good day. Life is horrible. Can't do anything right. Right? But when things are good, what do? And you stretch out, and you got a little bit more of a stance when you walk, and your shoulders are back, and you're making good eye contact, and you have joy in your face, and you feel powerful. Everything is linked to your emotions. So what does that tell you? It means your thoughts control you. It controls everything about your nonverbal communication. If you think negatively, or you think pessimistically, or you think that you'll never reach the top, guess what? You won't. Because everything about you is going to present that sign of defeat, not of prosperity. So what do we need to do? We've got to change our thoughts, what? So to change our outcome. we actually can predict our outcome just really by our thoughts. So we've got to change the way we think in order to exhibit better nonverbal communication. It's interesting, this past weekend was a very difficult time. I'll tell you a little story. My fiance's dad's not feeling well. He's suffering from cancer. Things have been tough, right? So everything I heard for 4 days was everything was horrible. Everything was bad. Nothing was good. Guess what my body language did after 4 days? I really needed to go get injected with some powerful, powerful words and change my thoughts to change my outcome. Amen? That's right. Okay, so we're going to talk about our words too. I think I may have passed by that. All right, now let's go forward. All right, so anyway, I got a question for you. Do you think that leaders smile more or less? You think they smile more? Ah. See, this is one thing that ladies that we have to be really careful of. Exactly. See, when we are in a transactional relationship, when we're talking about something that's really important, we have to put that game face on. That neutral face that I'm serious, not the mean look, not the reek, not that look, okay? But it's that the game face is that I'm on, right? You're attentive, you're listening, your face has more of a neutral affect. When the leaders smile less, not more. Okay, so do leaders move more or do they move less? They move what? They move less. That's exactly right. So just to kind of give you an example, when you're talking, if you're doing a presentation and you want to give a very good strong point, you can talk, you plant when you're sending that strong message. Then you can move when you're talking, talk, 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 plant. Okay? So you actually move less. Do leaders interrupt more or do they interrupt less? They interrupt more. So leaders have learned how to inject quickly without offending, okay? So let's just say, how many of you have ever been around someone that continues to talk, and guess what, you figured out, when am I going to be able to jump in there? And you're just patiently waiting and waiting and waiting. So what you do is when you hear them talking and you pick up on a key word, you go, you know what, that was a great point. I want to share with you something else that I learned. For example. So you hitchhike off of what they're saying, you change your tone, and then you redirect. Because otherwise, most people will talk your ear off, and you'll never get anything done. Okay, so do leaders keep their head, do they keep their head still, or do they tilt their heads when they're listening? Uh-huh, they tilt their head. So that's what we call that listening position. All right, so ladies, one thing that we have to really be careful of as communicators, because our greatest strength is our empathy and compassion, guess what we do? Oh, yes, I know, I understand. Mm-hmm. I get it. Yep. Oh, yeah, I had the same thing happen to me. Yes. So we tend to become the bobblehead. So here's what you do. You tilt your head in a good listening position. You lean forward. You nod a couple of times. And it's an affirmation that I hear you. And then you put your head back up again. But if you keep your head this way, it will actually weaken you, then strengthen you. So be careful of not over-tilting or doing the bobblehead. The two words are the strongest. These two words is what we call I am. How many times do we say, I am not, I can't, I won't, I coulda, I shoulda, I woulda? You could keep shouldn't and wouldn't all over yourself, and where are you going to go? Nowhere. The most powerful words you could ever use is the power of I am. If you do not start doing more I ams in the morning, you will leave the house already defeated. You wake up in the morning and say, I am great. I am powerful. I am a voice to be reckoned with, and I am passionate about what I do. How many of you do that in the morning? That's awesome. For a long time, I didn't. I would say it, but I didn't feel it. See, I have to say it, and you have to say it until you can feel it. Big difference. So I now want, we're going to kind of keep your little group here, I want each person around the in your table here, I want everyone of you to say what you're really great at. And when you say you're really great at it, all of you are going to choose who do you think that really presented that the strongest, or what were you really, really proud of? What accomplishment did you just make? It could have been yesterday, could have been a week ago, could have been a month ago. But whoever it is in this group that you choose, what I would like for you to do is then say, have that person stand up, the person that had the greatest accomplishment, I want you to stand and I want you to raise your hands out, and I want all of you at the table and I want you to cheer like a cheerleader for her. I want you to jump for joy. Yes, you did it. You're awesome. That's incredible. Wow. I want you jumping and up for joy and feel the energy that you need to have to propel yourself to be successful out there. Go. Stand up and cheer. I want to hear it. Stand up and cheer for her. Yes. Amazing. Wonderful. Powerful. I want to hear it. I want to hear the excitement. Great. Come on. Wave. All righty. Who said this? Who said these words? I am great. I am smarter. I am really rich. I am hugely successful. You named it, Donald Trump. I had an epiphany with everything that I've been teaching for years of the power of I am. If you tell yourself that on a regular basis, guess what? You're going to start to believe it. Isn't it crazy? You're going to start to believe it. All right, power move number one. You want to look really, really, really important? Do the steeple. Matter of fact, Mr. or Mr. So-and-so, you have the steeple. This is power move number one. Now, how many of you watch Shark Tank? Mr. Wonderful? The problem with Mr. Wonderful is he never loses the steeple. I want you to think about Donald Trump. Do you ever see him seated and he does the steeple? Yes. Here's what happens. Now, when we see Shark Tank, Mr. Wonderful, he does this because his pose. That's his signature. He made that his signature. But it becomes
redundant. It kind of loses its, you know, its intensity because you hold it for so long. That's like what we call overfacing. That's like when you hold something too long, it becomes animated and it doesn't become believable. But when you're talking, and I've watched experts when they've testified in court, and they're talking about a specific part of their DNA evidence or whatever, they naturally, because they feel very, the very important point, they will naturally steeple. Then they'll open their hands back up again. The other power move is that they're expressive. The greatest nonverbal communicators in this entire world are Italians. They can talk, and they don't even have to say the words. They just say them with their hands and gestures as if it's in living color. When you use hand gestures when you talk, it helps to fill in the story and helps others to visually see what you're talking about. Now, here's the problem. When we over-gesture, or ladies, when we get excited, where do our hands go? I mean, even Donald Trump did the flipper. Okay? So when he's losing control, he's not sure he was turned into the flipper. You know what I mean? But anyway, when you're using your hand gestures and you're using them very rapidly and you're going way outside your box, which is what I call between your shoulders and your hips, you will look like you're out of control. Especially if I'm speaking to you, I'm going to position my body towards you and I'm going to stay within my frame. All I'm going to do is move my hand gestures out, in, up, or down. You know, palms down, palms up. I might make movements this way. You know who was really great with this? President Obama. The most beautiful orator, the most phenomenal nonverbal communicator. Everything had its purpose, and it was very fluid. Women, be careful of making very strong, punching type of gestures. I know we feel sometimes we have to be a little bit more aggressive, but what happens is that we are less likable when we do that. So just be more fluid when you're speaking and talk within your frame, moving out, moving in, hands down, palms up. When we want collaboration and feedback, we use our palms up. So-and-so, tell me what you think. Anyone else in the group? That's how you use your palms up. This is honesty. When you want to make a very good point, you flip your hands around. Well, this is our plan. This is what we're going to do. But see, I also now pounced my hands. This is our plan. I'd like to share it with you. Would you like to tell me a little bit about yourself? So palms up, palms down. What we found, which was really interesting, is that they analyzed many different presidential candidates over the years and found that a presidential candidate that would use their dominant hand, it was when they were speaking about something that they felt very passionate about or strong about, but when they didn't like their opponent, guess what they did? They switched to their non-dominant hand. You know, they come over here and they talk, and then when they shift, know that when you see the shift, there's a shift of mind. Always a shift of mind, unless they're giving you a timeline. I'm coming from here and we're going here. If you don't hear those words and they're not synced together, they're not congruent. Power move number 3. I am heard. Being authentically there and available is highly important. The person that you're talking with and when you're networking with them, they have to feel that they need to feel from you that you are hearing them. We talked about this actually in the back room, and we talked about networking. You know what the problem with some networking is? When we come in, we come in with an agenda. And all we want to do is hand out as many business cards as we can, and you want to get your point across. You want to make the connection for you. You know when you start really getting the money? When you do the paradigm shift and it's all about you. They could care less about us. They want to know what you can do for me. So here's what you do. You listen to them talk. You pick up on what they're saying. Tell me what you do. Oh, it's not like, oh, that's great. What's the weather like outside? Oh, it's warm. Those are just, there's no meat to it, right? Tell me what you like about what you do. What is your position? Well, what is your day-to-day thing that you do? Oh, so you're a communications expert. Oh, okay, so what does that actually mean? But it's not like, what does that actually mean? It's, what does it actually mean, right? Tell me more, and let them talk. And then you can hitchhike off of what they're saying and say, you know what, that's a great point. Interrupting, that's a great point. You know, at our company, we have a great program, XYZ, that I know you would love. Do you mind if I give you my card? Great, thank you so much. Big difference, wouldn't you say? It's just shifting. One thing that I learned as a speaker is that I'm not the one on stage. I'm just the messenger. You guys are the ones that hold the stage, because without you, I could never be a leader because I wouldn't have any followers. In order to be a leader, you gotta have followers, right? So if it's all about me, people are gonna get kind of sick of that. All right. I am involved. You know, involved meaning that you're engaging, you're participating. And let me share something with you. I know, because I work with a lot of people that, you know, they just don't know how to get it inject into a conversation. The most way to inject is you don't have to really talk a lot. You just have to use some little minimal encouragers. For example, when the other person's talking and you want to know more, you say, really? And then? How interesting. Tell me more. Just little prompters to get them to talk more. But be engaged. Right now with social media so prevalent, people have a harder time engaging. Big time, right? You know, it's amazing, and we all know this, and I'm, myself included, standing in a restaurant waiting to be called with, you know, four or five friends, and we're all doing this. Nobody's talking. I see more kids coming my way from parents that with kids that are involved in social media that they can't even connect or they don't even have any friends, and they're sitting in the lunchroom by themselves. It's very sad. So the power move is get involved. What that means is you lean forward and you're an active participant. If you're leaning back, an observer, is that someone that's involved? Or is that an observer? And it may come across as being what? Judgmental, right? Disengaged. So lean forward, be involved. The other one is we talked about the palms up. And we already talked about this. Palms up is feedback, collaboration. When you open your fingers up like this, that means you're going to be more open with other people when you see that. I'm going to tell you the honest truth. This is how I feel. You'll see that their fingers open. You'll never see them with their fingers closed and saying that. I just really want to tell you how I feel. It doesn't happen. Remember, everything you're thinking and feeling is going to be what? Exhibited through your what? Your body language. Here's Oprah. I am confident in a visionary leader. She's got her steeple up high. See the difference? Here I'm going to do a business deal. Let me think about it. Right here is someone that's thinking outward and upward. Her eyes are going there. So are her hands. That's telling you she is a visionary leader. Our greatest strength as ladies is our compassion. Our empathy, our compassion, our female part of us is the greatest thing that we have with connecting with people. No wonder why Maria says we're stealing 70% of all this out there. No wonder why we're just greater connectors. Okay, so we're going to avoid a few things. Too many head tilts, not to condense your body language. What happens is that when you don't feel good, it's seen this way. We kind of contract. So when you see yourself doing that, think about, what am I thinking about right now? I don't want to be here. I'm tired. I need to make a coffee. I got things to do. Just automatically shift and open. And your entire physiological Your mental state of mind will start to change. Don't act so girlish. What I mean by that is that's the one that giggles. Have you ever met anybody that every time you talk to them is like giggle with everything that they say? Everything is funny. It's not going to be taken very seriously. So there's a time to smile politely. So here's the thing is you can build rapport. You smile gently. You don't freeze the smile. And then when you're talking about something very important, you have a natural affect, a neutral affect. Again, women tend to nod their head too much. They tend to be overly expressive sometimes. Wow, really? Unless they're standing on the stage or they're an actor, it's probably not a good idea, especially if you're sitting with somebody that's not as expressionless or expression, has strong expression. I mean, how many of you ever been to go to the coffee pot on Monday morning and you go to get a cup of coffee and you run into Miss Happy? Hi, I'm so excited. You wouldn't believe what happened this weekend. It was just so great. I'm so excited. Everything's wonderful. And she's like, oh, God, I just need my cup of coffee. Help me. Right? So what we find is when you run around Miss Happy, what you have to do is just bring it up just a little bit like, oh, hi. Rather than like, hi. If you bring it up a notch, they'll come down a notch. We found that to be true. So if you kind of go up or down one way or the other, they'll actually start to meet you more in towards the middle. All right. The delicate handshake, you know, the handshake that is in, the one that the we all know that one, right? The limp fish. But I have still, you know, shaken the hands of CEOs, and I still get the... It makes me feel like they think I have germs. And then on top of it, it's clammy and sticky. You know which ones I'm talking about. You might even have them yourself, okay? So, but a good confident handshake is when you come out and you're not shaking their hand to where you're waiting for something to fall off. You just give them a nice confident handshake, make eye connection. Nod your head two or three, it's nice to meet you, smile gently, and then pull your hand back. One thing I got to tell you, it's kind of interesting, that the power of, can I have a guy come up on stage here? Maybe you over here with this nice, handsome gentleman with the glasses. Come on up here. You remember when President Obama in his second election, and you had Mitt Romney, remember the two of them? All right. Well, what's interesting is that men do this. They shake your hand, and if they want to have more power, first of all, they'll turn your hand down, and they'll try to gain your power or take control of that. But what they did during that, what I noticed that President Obama did, is that what Mitt Romney did, when President Obama came out, and he actually was in more in a weakened position, remember when he didn't do a very good, he had a really bad night? Romney picked up on that, and as what happened is that President Obama, pulled his hand away. Mitt Romney did this, right? What he was saying is that I am more in power. So what President Obama did was hit me, okay? And then he did the same thing. He grabbed his hand. He goes like this. There was this power struggle, right? So then what happens is that Mitt Romney, he had the upper hand. He tended to move away. And what does the president, you start to move away. This is what Obama did. He just wanted to mark his territory. He was the one in control. All righty. So we're going to talk about powering up a little bit. And you may have seen a little bit of this through the TED Talk with Amy Cuddy. Has anyone ever seen that? Yes, a lot of you have. There's a lot of research that backs that up. We find that when you're in a high-stakes situation, like, you know, you're going to meet a client for the first time, you're nervous, you have a lot to lose or to gain, the anxiety level is pretty high to perform, that's the time where you want to empower yourself by putting on a power move. Power moves are ones where you expand your body language. You just expand and do the Superman pose, or you do a victory pose, or you lean on a table like you're in control, and you hold it for 3 to 5 minutes, and what we found is that it increases your testosterone level by 25%. Now, men, I always say you might want to do that. I'm just saying. You know, maybe, hey, honey, I'll be right there. Just kind of increasing my testosterone here a minute. All righty. On the other hand, we found that when you contract during those times, they did hormone testing and found that you actually depleted your testosterone and increased your female hormone by 25%, minimizing the amount of confidence that you would have. So when you get really nervous, you get ready to go in, wasn't you're going to go ask for a raise, just say, for example, what do you do? You're sitting there going, oh, my God, am I going to do it? Oh, I'm really nervous, right? What are you doing? Decreasing your power. So I want you to stretch out, put your arm back over that table. I want you to kind of spread out like an eagle and fly, because that's going to help you to increase your power. Interesting, this gentleman here, I love him. You know, he came across the finish line, right? The interesting thing is he was blind. He didn't know that you hold your hands up in victory. But his body naturally responds. It's how the body is. It's all interconnected. Ladies and gentlemen, there is so much here, it's mind-boggling. In fact, all the new technology that's coming out is learning how to read emotions of you based on your facial expressions. Robots. Apple now just bought an app so that people can, you know, if it's a physician that's talking to a patient and they have an avatar, they know how to program these robots to have the muscles move in the right movement to be able to engage with a human with the exact same expression of empathy or compassion or whatever it is. In fact, I just created one. I created a program where it actually reads your emotions and it spits back feedback, and it's an unbiased view or unbiased opinion about how you're actually thinking about me. So if I had the cameras all on you and I went back in the feed and look at the feed, I would be able to tell you exactly what you thought of me. That's where we're going. And it's all based on your facial expressions. There's 42 muscles in the face, and they move when you're feeling a certain emotion, and they're all universal. Wherever you live in the entire world, you all share the same exact expression. And when you're victorious, or you're happy, if you're sad, if you're disgusted, if you're angry. Emotions are powerful, you agree? Look at our world. It's all driven by emotions, and then the emotions do what? Causes us to react. They're all connected. So are these. And when they're feeling, you know, reptiles, when they feel powerful, they're getting ready to attack, they spread. I just want to let you know, don't come near me. Right? I'm big and I'm broad and I'm mighty. That's what animals do. Reptiles do just like humans. So ladies, I want you to all assume the position. Stand up. I want you to give me the greatest superwoman pose and or Superman pose, excuse me. And I want you to repeat this. I am wonderfully and purposefully made. I want you to hear that.
I am wonderfully and purposely made.
Did you feel it?
Yes.
I want to hear that one more time.
I am wonderfully and purposely made.
There you go. I am, now do this, I am an expert.
I am an expert.
I am victorious.
I am really smart.
I am
really
smart.
I am confident.
I am confident. And I got a little bit of hip. I got a little bit of attitude, too. All right, you can go ahead and take a seat, ladies. Just know that your body language will control your outcome. Everything you're thinking and feeling will be exhibited through your nonverbals. Change your thoughts, and every morning I want you to give yourselves at least 3 I ams. Thank you, everyone.
Wow. What do y'all think? What do you think about Susan? Oh my goodness, amazing. Absolutely phenomenal. Could you imagine having the opportunity to work with Susan one-on-one? Could you imagine what you could accomplish and how you could truly break through some of the barriers that you may have that are keeping you from flying like an eagle, like she said earlier. So the great news is Susan has a program called Breakthrough. And be sure before you leave tonight that you visit her over at her vendor table and talk to her about her special women's leadership event discount for working with her one-on-one. It's a wonderful opportunity for you to be able to have someone like her coaching you to the next level. All right, so Mary Beth.
Absolutely. Okay, so this is one of my favorite parts about my job. All of the proceeds from this event go directly to students. Students, yes. So we are thrilled about that. And so we would like to present, Maria and I would like to present a scholarship to a very deserving student. Now, the criteria for this scholarship is the student must be a current student, demonstrate need. The criteria is they have to have a 3.9 GPA or higher, okay? And then they have to represent global professionalism, right? A part of our global for professionalism standards at Full Sail. So, Maria, will you help me identify the scholarship recipient?
Absolutely. I am so excited to be able to honor tonight and to recognize this year's recipient of our Women's Leadership Initiative Scholarship with a 3.97 GPA. Please come up to the stage, Alexis Gilmore.
Alexis
Gilmore. Come on up.
Who does not know. It's a big surprise.
And I want you to know that Alexis will graduate in February with a degree in digital art and design, and we are so proud of her.
Way to go.
Stand up for Alexis.
Look at that, a standing ovation.
We are so proud of you.
Oh, you're so welcome.
Congratulations. So excited.
So let's get
our picture taken. We're going to get a picture.
Way to go. You're welcome so much. So well deserved.
And you get to keep the big check, too. I can't wait to see you taking that to the bank. That'll be pretty cool.
That's great. So in addition to the Women's Leadership Initiative Scholarship, one of our sponsors, who we've had the opportunity to work with in the past, Women of AT&T is a part of Global Entrepreneurship Week to present a scholarship to a deserving student as well. Come on up, Josie. Good to see you.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, wait, also this one.
Oh, yes. And
Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying your evening. I'm Josephine Vasquez Rivera. I'm the president of Women of AT&T's Florida chapter. Women of AT&T is an employee resource group, and it's a nonprofit organization composed of AT&T employees. We have a few of them here in the house.
Yes. Woo!
We're focused on connecting and inspiring our employees to achieve their personal and professional goals and effect change in the communities that we work and live in. We provide opportunities for women to develop and demonstrate their leadership skills, ensure professional and personal continuous growth, advancement, and we do this through education, mentoring, networking, and involvement in our communities. So, particularly, of course, in support of women and of recognizing the value that women contribute within and outside of AT&T. So with that mission in mind, and in conjunction with Global Entrepreneurship Week, we are so excited to award this scholarship of $1,000 to a deserving young lady, Miss Mackenzie Murphy.
Woo!
Mackenzie has a GPA of 3.8. She has a 103 Global Professionalism Standard. She's a film student who graduates in June 2017. So please join me in congratulating Mackenzie.
Surprise. Wasn't that great? That's one of the favorite parts of my job. So, remember we talked about networking, right? And now I'm like, what pose should I do? want to bring up Jessica Vick, who is basically responsible for this event. She's done a great job. What do you guys think? Jessica is our operations manager for staff and cultural development. You're going to share a little bit about our networking activity.
Yes. Wow, you guys look powerful. Do you feel powerful? Yeah. Okay, well, now that you've had a little bit of time to mingle with the vendors, we want you guys to connect with each other, right? That's why we're here. So we're passing around another networking activity. You'll see our volunteers coming around. So when you get this networking book, there's a sheet in there. You're going to have three prompts. I want you all to connect with someone you don't know. We're gonna do that three different times. Once you've done all the prompts, you've gotten all of your initials, there's little instructions there, so if you forget all of this, don't worry, it's in the book for you. Turn it into the full sale table for a chance to win an awesome prize. Sound good? Yeah, all right, prizes are always fun. Well, we'll be walking around, so if you have any questions about the activity, let us know, and happy networking.
How many minutes do we have?
We have about 20 minutes for the networking activity, and I'll be giving you some alerts on the mic as well, so we'll let you know when we're winding down.
Awesome. We'll be right back.
Yeah. When? Tell me when.
You're ready.
All right, I hear some awesome conversation happening. We have about 5 more minutes left for the networking activity, so if you haven't made it to that third prompt, go ahead and meet somebody new, and be sure to turn your paper into the full sale vendor table.
Ladies, how are we doing? How is the networking going? All right, we are in the home stretch now. And I'd love to hear a couple of your takeaways from this evening. We've got two microphones, one on the left side over here, one on the right side over here. Does anyone want to share their takeaways from this evening? Raise your hand if you do. Are we still involved in too much conversation? Yes, I know the networking is very important. All right, Cassie and Josie are networking.
I'm a real estate agent, so.
Oh my gosh.
Does anyone have a great takeaway from this evening? Josie, you have a takeaway? Jessica?
Yeah, we got a good one over here.
All right, ladies. We've got a takeaway here from one of our guys. We want to hear from you now. It's your turn to turn the microphone over to you. Carolyn, do you have a takeaway from this evening?
Yes. Hi, my name is Carolyn Izzo. I work for Polyblocks Totems, and I think I just sold my house. I just met this wonderful real estate agent, and I think I'm going to move forward with it. And when my husband says, "What the hell?" I'm just going to go, "We're doing it."
Way to go, Carolyn. All right. Woo! Yes, victory pose, everyone. All right. Any other takeaways from this evening? Josie.
Be mindful of what you say, both verbally and non-verbally.
Way to go. Thank you. Anyone else have a takeaway here? Do you guys still want to continue networking? It sounds like you do. Any other takeaways? Then is it time for giveaways? All right, ladies. Time for some giveaways. Jessica, are we using those? Okay, so we got 7 giveaways. We'll do 3 from here and 4 from here. We got a couple more from Karen. All right, ladies, is Renee Wrigley in the house? Renee Wrigley. All right, giveaway for Renee. Next one is Polyblocks Totems. Carolyn Izzo gets a prize. All right, let's see here. How about Diane Lars from Bridges International? All right. Let's see, how about Kathy Droke? All right, Kathy. All right, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 more. Christy Park. All right, Christy, she's back here. 2 more, put them in the bowl. Carol Brito, Carol, gets a prize giveaway. All right, last one. Stephanie Volrath from Volrath Law. Woo! Way to go, Stephanie. All right. So ladies, thank you so much for being here this evening. We still are able to network for a few minutes, but can you please help me thank Susan Constantine one more time?
Woo! Susan!
Woo! That's right, we are powerful. What are you gonna implement tomorrow, right? Are we gonna say, did everyone take a picture of what we're gonna say to ourselves tomorrow for 3
Absolutely.
Minutes?
Absolutely.
Good. All right, so Maria?
I want to thank all of you for joining us tonight. And I want to let you know that Edward Jones is committed to serving our clients and our communities through a diverse group of financial advisors. And we hope that this event has provided you with an opportunity to learn new ideas, meet new people, and consider how you can impact others' lives in a meaningful way. So we thank you so much for being here. You're welcome to hang out and talk to one another, and we can't wait to see you at our next Women's Leadership Initiative. Thank you so
much. That's right. Thank you guys so much. Please expect an email from us because we want to know how you feel about this, because we want to do this again if you're interested, okay?
Yeah, you're going to get a survey monkey.
You're great. All right, let's continue to network.
Shooting star, you're beautiful the way you are. amazing, turn a phrase into a